Hey, Jacques Habra here, talking about success rule number five. I put together a list of rules that I like to share in a lot of my lectures, especially when I'm talking to younger people. But number five, do what you say you're going to do. It applies to everyone, regardless of age. It's really remarkable how in practically every industry and every walk of life and almost every scenario, how truly rare it is that people consistently do what they say they're going to do. And I wanted to break this down a little bit because I think it's a misunderstood declaration. It's so often perceived as simply, you know, always showing up and always executing. But actually, there's a first part about it in terms of what you say that's really critical here. Obviously, life happens, and you're not going to be able to fulfill every single one of the promises that you make. You're going to be running late at times. Things are going to fall through. You're going to be tired. You're going to get sick. Something else is going to arise to cause you not to do something that you said you were going to do. But the really critical aspect of that declaration is what you say. And you want to monitor what you say to others and to yourself very carefully, because therein lies the synchronicity in your actions. And this is often overlooked or kind of forgotten about. Be cautious and thoughtful about what you say. When you make a promise, you know, process it, look at your calendar, do some self-assessment, analyze your own capacity, your own ability to deliver. And that will cause you to make statements, to say things that you actually can follow through on. It's all about increasing the percentage of how often you actually do what you say you're going to do. And so start by being really thoughtful and mindful of what it is that you say. So the second aspect to consider is that actual percentage, increasing the percentage. I don't think anyone on planet Earth ever operates at 100%. Maybe a monk does, because they almost never say anything, and the few things they say, they certainly do. But most of us are not going to operate at 100%. The question is, where are you operating? Are you operating at 20%, at 50%, at 70, at 80, at 90? Try to get a sense of that without being too pedantic or self-scrutinizing. I think it's worth analyzing. Maybe get an idea of the percentage that you live under. Do you live at around 60 or 70%? And I challenge that if you increase that percentage, even marginally, even by 5 percentage points, that your quality of life will go up and that your success metrics will go up. So there you have it, a little bit of deconstruction on doing what you say you're going to do, rule number five for success.